Electric field imaging system, that's a new technology. People have tried to look at electric fields coming from just the electron itself, and generally it fails because every time you try and make a measurement, the object that you're using to measure it with distorts the field. And so electric field imaging is a method to image those fields, and you do it by putting a sensor in that does not disturb the field. It's the quantitative measurement of the electric field. Others that have worked in the area generally have looked at signatures, not a quantitative measurement. It works in two ways. And here we are being photographed. We have a camera and we have a light. Electric field images is very similar to analogous to that. If you can illuminate objects with electric field, and you can see how that field is distorted by the presence of the object. Every time I turn one of my systems on, I find a new thing that I never knew about. For space systems, for example, plasma, we have plasma flow and things like that. We want to be able to control it. Well, you really generally can't see some of the plasmas. And so if you can image the plasma, you can identify how the controls are changing the plasma flow. Outside NASA, immediate applications are for looking at the integrity of power systems and also safety. One of the issues with power systems is if it's not grounded properly, you can have a problem with your system, power and things like that, but also personnel safety. Baggage inspection. Additive manufacturing has come forward where people can now make weapons out of all plastic. You can actually image through the container to identify those, and they light up like light bulbs in this case because they're generally polymer systems. We never knew that when people walk on the floors, rugs, their footprints are left electrostatically and you can see them. Those footprints stay there for days. And so you can actually have some forensic activity where you can look and see what happened, where everybody was walking around. I think the biggest impact, you'll start to see things like your cardiac system and your nervous system, you'll start to image those areas. If I introduce the more sensitive sensors, in terms of medical applications, you can identify what problems are in the sense that you're now imaging the nervous system and the cardiac potentials. It's a very low-cost system. You could build one for a few $100s if you wanted to. It's also real-time, and you could do multiple dimensions. It's going to sell itself. I don't have to sell it.
This NASA technology and many others are ready to be transferred to your business. Find out more by visiting technology.nasa.gov.